Hello and welcome everyone. Welcome to my another webinar. And in this webinar, we are going to talk about Netlify, how you can host your website on Netlify, where you already have a domain purchased from GoDaddy. So how you can do the hosting on the Netlify for different kind of application, like you have written some Gatsby blog or you have some React application, some Angular application. Everything can be hosted using Netlify. So Netlify will have your application content, and the domain you might have purchased from GoDaddy, BigRock, or from Netlify itself. Okay, so we'll get started with Netlify, how to work with Netlify, how to deploy your application to Netlify, how you can do your GitHub integration with Netlify. So whenever you do a code change in the GitHub source code, that gets automatically deployed to your website. So this is how you do, like you create a React application or some Gatsby blog. You keep publishing the data on that Gatsby blog and that automatically getting published onto your website. Okay. So you just need two things before we get started. You just need to have a Netlify account. Either you can do a sign up using GitHub, Bitbucket or GitLab, or you might be having some GoDaddy account where you have already purchased some domain like helloworld.com, some domain example like my own domain, which is tksharma.com. Okay, so we'll do a login with GitHub. Before that, we also need to find, okay, what I'm going to publish. So I'm looking at Gatsby starter blog. I'm going to use this blogger platform to deploy this, so I can actually use my own blogs with my own website. Okay, so like if I show you one simple example, this is my own blogging website, and what it does is I'm able to publish a lot of markdown blogs. So these are some markdown files, and I'm able to publish the markdown files through this Gatsby blog. Okay, but how is this possible? I'm just writing an everyday blog on my GitHub and pushing that readme markdown file that automatically getting published to this website because I have a GitHub integration with Netlify. So if you just take a look on to the GitHub, how this is working. So I already have a Netlify hook already added to this GitHub repository that we will see in the Netlify. So let's switch back here and log in. Okay, so I just need to authenticate myself. So just let me do it. Then we'll be able to enter to Netlify and we'll be able to add our applications. Okay, now I'm able to enter to Netlify, and here I can see all my applications, all my builds. Okay, so here if you want, first of all, what you need is you need to have one repository. Okay, like what I'm going to do is I'm going to clone this. I have forked this website and this website is now available, this repository. So I mean, you can also create a React application using Create React App or Angular application using Angular CLI. You just need to have some a repository created for front-end application which can be hosted, which can be deployed. Okay, so what we will do is now we will go to our Netlify section, and what you need to do is on the sites, create a new site from Git. Here you can do integration with GitHub, GitLab or Bitbucket. It's not necessary that your website or your repository for the front-end application is on GitHub only. Can be on GitLab, Bitbucket. What Netlify will do is Netlify will look into your repository and you will tell Netlify, okay, this is the repository I want to create a hook for. Okay, so my repository name is Gatsby starter blog. I will just connect to the GitHub. Okay, so it will just authorize me, and here I can search the repository. Repository name is based on this, you will search. Okay, we are able to see starter block. This we want to deploy. So it's a Netlify build, right? So it will automatically get these two steps: gets we build and public. So whenever gets we build command will run, it will create the output inside a public folder, all the static files. If it is a create React app, then it will be something like this: npm run build, and you will be exposing things from side build folder, right? Same for the Angular, same for the React, but here it is a Gatsby application. If it is going to be React application, then what you will do is, instead of Gatsby build, you will be writing npm run build, which will create a React build, and from build folder you will be showcasing your website, because the output of the build is going inside a public build folder. Here we are using Gatsby build, so let's keep it as a Gatsby build only. And now you can, what you can do is, what branch you are deploying, master or particular branch, so it is registering a hook against this master branch of your repository, and it will deploy site. So once the site is deployed, it will give you some kind of a canonical link. So if you see domain settings, now what you want, next step is, once this website is going to be deployed, we wanted to host it somewhere. Otherwise, Netlify will give us some vague URL, which we don't want. We want it on some domain like subdomain like blog.tksharma.com or myblog.tksharma.com. So currently it is building. Then we will see what is going to happen. Okay. Now what we will do is, if you have a GoDaddy account or BigRock or whatever, the domain provider, you just need to buy a domain, which is, I think, you can get it easily. So once you have a domain, you have to point this Netlify website to your domain, so that whenever you hit that domain, like mywebsite.tksharma.com or mywebsite.com, then it will look for this Netlify canonical URL, and your Netlify host will point to that domain name. Okay, for that we have to just do few things. Here we are already making deploy, so that is fine. Here you can see this is our application. So for site settings we have to go. Here we will see a lot of different things. Here we will domain management. Okay, here we have to add a custom domain. Custom domain, consider that you already have some domain, already you have purchased, is tksharma.com. Okay, what you wanted to do is now register a subdomain. So consider that I wanted to register myui.tks, my blog, let's see. Okay, this is the domain I wanted to register it. Verify. Yes, it's my domain. And now what you need to do is, you need to add this CNAME in your domain. So this is my blog is a CNAME, and that CNAME should point to this URL. Okay, that you have to configure it in GoDaddy. Okay, so here is my domain. So here is my domain, and I have all different kind of record, a record, a CNAME record, NS, and these are predefined records. So I can add something new, and what I need to select is the CNAME, canonical namespace we are adding. Okay, it is pointing to this blog should point to this URL of Netlify, and TTL is, you can say custom, I want just TTL is a 30,000 or 1,000 seconds. Okay, same as like this. So when I'm hitting devs.tksharma.com, this is pointing to this Netlify website. Okay, you can just save it. Host was, I think, my blog, not blog. So just verify it, my blog, and the record name is CNAME record, my blog, and just save it. And this is correct URL, app, okay. Now you have to wait for some time to reflect this, and we can just check how our application look like. because we did recently deployment, and here we can actually preview the website, how our logging website look like. Okay, this is the output I'm getting, right? This is nothing but this is just a template, Gatsby template, which we have deployed. Okay, now what we can do is we can just see how it is going to work. My blog dot, this is where we will be pointing. Yes, now you can see I'm able to host this website on my own domain, which is myblog.tksharma.com, and in some time it will be enabled, HTTPS will be enabled, and you'll be able to see everything. So here now you can see the Netlify build details, deploy settings are there, and here now your new website is available, right? So this is quick and very easy. What you need is you need just a GoDaddy account with some domain, because once you have a domain, you can create subdomains, and your subdomain can point to a different applications. Here, if you see this, this is my domain. Now it is pointing to, this is the canonical, the anonymous predefined some name which Netlify gives to every application. So myblog.tksharma.com is actually pointing to this. Okay, you can see the domain settings here. You can see now it is available. This application is available to the default subdomain and my own subdomain also, because when I'm hitting this, it is actually pointing to the Netlify domain. Okay, it is very easy to deploy any application. You just need to have a GitHub integration or GitLab or Bitbucket. You just push your code of your Create React application, Gatsby, Log, or Angular CLI. Okay, just configure your application. So here it is very easy, new site. Here you can connect with any of your account, and then if it is a React application, if it is a Gatsby application, add your appropriate build command, and from where the site is going to pick your index.html, obviously from the build folder. So it will pick from the build folder, it will host your application. But we always need some custom domain available. So for that custom domain, you just need to go to your GoDaddy, add a CNAME, a record, and point your CNAME subdomain to this one, and your site will be live. Okay, I hope this is very helpful. You can create your own blogging website, same as like Medium. Not feature wise same as Medium, but you can have your own blogging where you can write a markdown blogs and you can publish them, and you can have your own domain available. So this is a quickest and easiest way to deploy your website, and this is how I do it. Thanks everyone.